presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to play up to three videos at once in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I help you learn all about ProPresenter, of course. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. So this is something that actually came up in my own church. We've got Pro Video Player, also a Renewed Vision piece of software, but we wanted to do something with MIDI controls that is easier to do in ProPresenter 7, and we've got the site license, so we have extra licenses. So they asked me, is it possible to play, say, two videos at once? I said, oh yeah, I think I could do that. They said, what about three? I said, pretty sure I could do three. So some people have asked me why in the world you'd want to do this. Well, imagine this, that you have an LED wall up front that's a different aspect ratio than the side screens, and you want to play a video, only you want the two videos to be formatted slightly differently for the two different screens. Let's say that it's Vacation Bible School. Same situation, but now you want a third video on the stage screen that is the motions that the kids go through when they sing their songs. But you don't want to show that on the two output screens because it's only for the leaders that are up there in case they forget what they're doing. The kids wouldn't, but, you know, us adults sometimes do. So if that's the case, then what would you do? How would you accomplish that? Well, you do this. So let's head over to my computer and take a look. So the first thing that I've done is I've created a preview. This has three different preview screens in it. So that way we can see all three of them playing at once. Of course, you need three screens if you want to do this. I guess you could maybe show two on one screen under certain circumstances, but let's just say that that's what you want. So we need to go into screens, configure screens, and make sure that we have three. I actually have five output screens and three stage screens right now, so let me explain what each of those is. This operator screen, that's the one we're looking at, so that's what that's for. This would be my regular stage screen. So this is the one that is going to show to the people that are up front leading and everything. And then I'm going to use my main output and my live stream to send to other things. So I've got those three screens. Now, that's thing one. Is I've got to have those three screens. Thing two is I've got to put the videos on different layers and have those trigger simultaneously. So how do I do that? Well, let me create a new presentation. So add news. Actually, it's not down there. Silly me. It's up here. So new presentation. Let's call this three videos for no other reason than so that I remember next time that I have three videos. First thing, I'm gonna put something on the slides layer. Now I could go into the editor and put it there, but here's a little trick that you may not know. So let's do this one. I'm gonna just put that there. And I'm going to right click on it, and then there is a choice here that is convert media action to slide element. So that basically moves it up onto the slides layer. So there we go. Notice that the icon that was up here went away. Now let's add this one on the media layer. So it's down here. Let's make sure it's set as a background. Yeah, it is. Good. So I'm going to drag that just directly on there. Notice that the icon came back because I've got a video behind it. Now, for the tricky part, you might think, oh, well, I'll just use the announcements layer. Not as easy to do. What we should do is we should skip up a layer from the announcements layer to the props layer. So let's go down here to the props show control. If these icons are up here, you've got an out-of-date version of ProPresenter. So go to make sure you update to that. And let's create a new prop. So I click on the little plus button right here and add that. And let's call this dark blue video. Okay. And then I'm going to right click and go to edit. And let's go down to the dark blue video here. And I'm going to click on this plus button. This editor looks a whole heck of a lot like the regular editor, and that's on purpose. So this would be the way that you would add the a video either way. You could use the same technique to add it onto the slides layer directly, keeping in mind that if you add it onto the slides layer, it will only play while that particular slide is up. So that's why we don't normally do that. We normally have that on the media layer. So I'm going to select media, and I have that down here in there it is. So I've got it down here. I think it's Grayflow Night here. Let me just hit the, yeah, that's the one I want. So I'm going to select open here. I've already brought this in, so it's going to ask me if I want to use the current version. So let's use existing. Okay. And now that's there. So now I have the media layer, I have the slides layer, and I have a prop, but I haven't triggered that prop. So I've got a couple of ways that I can do that. I could right click and add an action and go to props and select dark blue video, and that would trigger it. Or down here in the lower right-hand corner, I could create a macro that would do the exact same thing. This time, I'm just going to do an action. So the only reason that you would do an action versus a macro is if you only wanted to do that once, whereas if you're doing the exact same thing week in and week out, having a macro is like a saved action. So just some little differences to keep in mind. And I'm going to go down to props and add the dark blue video prop. And so we see the props icon indicating that when I click on this, it should trigger everything. Finally, we need to make sure that if I go into edit looks, that I have on each of those screens, I have the appropriate video on the appropriate output. So I have the main output that is showing messages. Don't need that this particular instance, but it's there. But it's also showing the slide. So the video that's on the slide layer will show. The live stream here is showing the media layer. So the video that's on the media layer will show, but nothing else. And the stage screen video output, which is a placeholder screen that is set to show the video. I do not have the props showing on any other layer, so other than alpha, but I'm not previewing that. So props will get the stage screen video. The live stream will get the media video, and the main out will get the live stream video. So it should be the case. Let me click save here. That, when I click on that, let me hide that. Okay, so we've got two videos playing at once. For some reason, one of them is duplicating the other. So perfect time to do a little troubleshooting, and that is, let's think, what this particular one is, my live stream. So not my live stream, it's my stage screen. So if we go to stage screen, yep, that's what we're seeing. So let's go to view. It could be that what I did was, sorry, screens, edit layouts. The layout that I'm using for the stage screen is, and I need to go through and delete a bunch of these. The video clip layout, and I think that's exactly what I did. Yep, I didn't change that from the main out to a screen preview of the stage screen video out. So now, yep, now it's showing that. So going back to the preview, the operator screen, now we see all three of those. Let me clear out those screens here, and let's go ahead and try it again. If I click on that, then it shows the three different videos playing at the exact same time. And so that's how to do that in ProPresenter 7. If you're curious how to show a video on the stage screen only, that's another tutorial. Once that's up, I'm about to record it, then I will go ahead and put a link to that in the description below the video so that you can see that one as well. If you like this content, I bet you'd like my Pro 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/Pro7Quick, and in three or four lessons, I'll get you up to speed on some of the cool stuff that's included in ProPresenter 7. It's a fundamentals back to basic approach. So just put in your name and email address so I can create a login for you, and I'll send that to you automatically. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com.